up? It's your girl, Sasha Banks, the legit boss. You are watching Going In Raw. You like that?
Hey, Brendo, Steve here.
And Lars.
And welcome back to Going In Raw, the only pro wrestling podcast you'll be listening to right here at youtube.com/ Steve and Larson, available wherever podcasts can be found. And of course, filmed live on the Twitch, twitch.tv/ Steve and Larson. We're on the road to 1,000 subs here on the Twitch.
Oh, yeah.
And once we get to 1,000, we're going to eat something really hot, like a pepper or like a chip or something. I don't know what they do.
Or a hot wing.
Or a
Is that chip challenge thing still a thing where they get you could buy like one super hot chip?
I'm old. I don't know these things anymore, but we can definitely
What's the new thing? What's the new thing in terms of testing your endurance with spicy foods?
Your guess is as good as mine, man. We'll have to rely on the friendos to let us know. That's going on over here on the Twitch. We're at 783 according to this counter, but
close.
Yeah,
let's try to get there by the end of the year.
By December 31st. You know what it's gonna take? We're gonna have to do one of them gaming streams, but like an 8-hour one, like a long one. The longer you're on, the more subs you get.
Yeah, the more subs you get, obviously. Yeah.
Then you go on a run and start talking about Bruce Green and stuff. It's great. Anyways, that's what we should do. We should ask Bruce Green to do like a game us.
We'll just be fun.
Tons of people coming in. Anyways, and we love Bruce Green. Even if he didn't bring anybody.
Bruce is great.
I'd still want to play
a great
game with him. He's
great.
I
miss Bruce.
I miss Bruce a lot. Anyways, Raw tonight. What was the biggest story coming out of Raw tonight?
Drew McInfart.
Drew McInfart and MVP cracking up at Matt Riddle, which was a great little moment. We have three participants in this triple threat that's happening next week to set up a number one contender.
They made the men's Survivor Series match matter a bit. So the show opened with Scrap Iron getting all the team members in the ring, and he was letting them each kind of campaign lobby as to why they should get a title shot against Drew. Braun got a little heated, laid out Scrap Iron. So in the end, there was three singles matches made with all the participants of Team Raw, save for Braun, because Scrap Iron wanted to fire him. If he had the power, he would have.
And then he just had endless lobbying coming his way.
Oh, his title shot, man.
Bobby Lashley, from Randy Orton. And so Braun escorted out the building, and he set up a series of matches which sort of defined the night, and then will lead into next week, which there'll be a triple threat to determine number one contender. And so we
Take on Drew McInfart,
To take on Drew McInfart. Well, those three contenders, or those three participants, are AJ Styles, Riddle, and Keith Lee.
Keith Lee. AJ's totally winning.
AJ is probably most definitely winning.
1,000%.
Yeah,
1,000%. All the confidence points, AJ Styles winning.
That sounds right, because there's two good guys, and Drew's a good guy. Although Drew and Keith Lee, they had a thing. But, AJ Styles makes sense. He ain't doing nothing else right now.
I was actually pretty surprised that Sheamus lost. I mean, it's a hell of a match. It's
really I would have given 1,000% to Sheamus when they started this thing tonight. You know?
Yeah, no.
I was wrong a lot tonight, though, man. I thought for sure the Hurt Business was going to pick up those tag titles, too.
Well, based on that that backstage segment before the match, I was like, oh, man, this is a gimme.
Yeah.
For Hurt Business, you know?
Yeah.
Just the whole thing. Cedric was on fire backstage. He was talking mad crap.
Man.
And he was awesome.
That was good stuff. Dude, let's just launch into it. So it kicked off, like you said, with Scrap Iron opening Raw. He had Team Raw with him. Recap Survivor Series. Congratulated Drew for his win last week to become WWE Champion. And he said he has Team Raw out here. They swept. Good job, everybody. He says, now I want you guys to each. I think it's a little bit unfair because it rewards the more articulate members of Team Raw, as opposed to people who might be better in the ring than others. He said, I want everybody to state your case as to why you should be number one contender.
Man, to be a pro wrestler, you need more than just in-ring skills.
It's like he's staging his own mini Tough Enough, isn't he?
You need the gift of gab.
Yep. He said, this is not the section where we are going to judge you on your in-ring prowess. It's going to be your promo skills.
Hey, man, if in-ring skill is all that mattered, they wouldn't have promo class at NXT.
That's a good point. Or they wouldn't have Eddie Kingston around at AEW. So anyways, Pierce says, I'm going to hand the mic off first to Team Captain AJ. I love this scrap by and refer. He acknowledges AJ Styles as team captain.
Well, and he has a C on his vest.
So yeah, well, and on his, I know, and on his trunks and his tights. And Sheamus is like, hold on a second. He's not my team captain. Sheamus talks about his relationship with Drew McIntyre, the champion, congratulates him being the champion, and he calls himself the MVP of Team Raw. AJ interrupts and says, hold on a second. I know, we all know that you've got a relationship with Drew McIntyre. You're going to try to use that relationship to use the good old boy system. That's not going to work. Team MVP, that's me. Of course it's me. I'm the team captain. And Keith
and
Lee's
Keith
like,
Lee interrupts.
Go ahead.
He says, I saved you, AJ. I pinned the SmackDown team captain. Was Jey Uso ever officially named the SmackDown team captain?
Oh, man, no. He's Team Cuck of Roman Squad.
To get the win, Riddle says, what they did last night was sick. He pinned Corbin. And so since he pinned Corbin, he wants to know if he gets Corbin's crown.
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, well, when I win all this, or if I get a match against Drew and beat him, then I'll get his dope sword, and mm-hmm. I'll have a dope sword and a dope crown.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sheamus gives him crap. He says, oh, you really are dopey. Your nickname
really
is
are
fitting.
Dopey.
And then Riddle's like, oh, Fireface. That wasn't even my first choice, but Firecrotch was taken.
Mm-hmm.
And then Braun's next. Pierce says, all right, Braun, what do you have to say? Last but not least. And Braun takes offense to that saying.
Yeah. Why is it Braun alternates between, like, dullard and guy who's
hothead,
like, not dullard? Because,
yeah,
like, okay, so a long time ago, he was, you know, when he's just the monster, he was a dullard. But, like, you know, he went through that phase where he was laughing and he would talk a lot and he was champion and he was, I mean, he could form sentences. And he doesn't know what last but not least means. It's not least. It's you're chronologically, yeah, you're going last, but you're not the least. Yes. It explicitly states you're not least.
And even after Braun got upset, Pierce had to explain it to him.
Yeah.
It's like, figure, yeah,
of speech.
You're last in order. However, that is no indication of quality of you as a performer or as a wrestler.
Right.
He grabs Pierce by the lapel, starts shaking him. And starts shaking him.
What are you doing? What are you doing to me?
And yelling at him. And then headbutts him.
Yeah.
And then, like, Pierce is knocked out.
That's our first commercial cliffhanger, Larson.
Yeah, we come back, and we go back in time earlier in the day as the Hurt Business is arriving at Thunderdome. And they run the New Day, and MVP says, oh, if it isn't the worst of the worst. Says you really embarrassed yourselves after losing to the Street Profits. And Shelton says, yeah, those titles need some prestige. We need title shot. And Woods is like, yeah, but what happened last week? And Cedric steps in. Did I get this right? Did Cedric say last time he was sitting on the sidelines? Did I hear that correctly?
He said, while I thought he was saying more along the lines of while Woods was building a career playing video games, he was sitting on the sidelines.
Gotcha.
That's
gotcha.
How I interpreted okay. it.
Gotcha. Anyways, he says, we're not asking, we're telling. He says he wants the spotlight where it belongs on Cedric. And Kofi's like, nah, Woods, it's our day off. You know, no match tonight. And Woods is like, no, we can't let him talk to us like that. You're on.
You know how I knew Cedric was super powerful here? He was gripping even with his face turned away from the camera because it was filmed so you could see Xavier's face, but Cedric was talking towards him and his back was sort of towards the camera. And still, it was so good. Like, Cedric so good. Has found an eighth gear with him being in the Hurt Business. It's really, really good stuff.
85% of the time, if someone's struggling in terms of mic work, being a face, just turn him heel.
Mm-hmm.
Just let him go.
I know. You know what I really appreciate about this, man? I texted you this. How many times do they start a Raw and there's been a match that's a rematch for no reason and they just say, oh, and tonight we're going to have this match? I love that it was like a 3-minute thing. And it motivated the damn rematch. It wasn't just some nebulous figure creates this match out of nothing. Although now we have Adam Pearce and he's the WWE official. Although I wish they'd give
but
him.
But he's
like
not nebulous. We know who he is.
He is scrap iron right there.
Yeah.
So I just like when and that got Raw off to a good start for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because
mm-hmm.
I'm like, oh wow, they're using logic. And sometimes it's in the it's the little things, the details. Too often WWE kind of just ignores those
things.
The thing
is, it doesn't take. You don't have to spend minutes, hours doing it.
I feel like more
people
give
us the bare minimum of justification.
Just more people in WWE creative needs to ask, okay, but why is this happening?
I know, more people need to ask why.
Yeah. Anyways, so at that point, when that was set up, I was like, oh, I wonder if they just delayed Hurt Business getting tag titles so that you can have more of a dream match situation with Street Profits versus New Day.
Yeah, and I thought the same thing. And everything about win that backstage tonight. Thing, it was oh, this is the Hurt Business's match to lose.
It's their day off. It's New Day's day off.
They're not prepared. This came off a hard-hitting match against Street Profits.
Yeah. I was actually
which they lost confidence down.
Yeah. I was a bit perplexed as to why they had the New Day win. But I guess just to sort of bring them back up, like, you know, the chips are down. They just lost to the Street Profits. You need to make sure everybody knows, hey, these guys are still really good. They're not going to lose again. I guess
there's
that's that. The
there's potentially interesting story to be told because, you know, the New Day, they won SmackDown titles, tag titles, while still on SmackDown, while still a three-man unit.
Yeah.
Of course,
yeah.
They traded tag belts with the Street Profits before during the draft.
Mm-hmm.
There's a story to be told there where they take that L to the Street Profits. Maybe their confidence is a little down. Maybe they're a little beat up. They're not whole, as in only two out of the three are on Raw.
Yeah.
They face up against Hurt Business. They take that loss. There's maybe a good story to be told there.
Yeah, it's not just that Big E over on SmackDown, if they ever utilize him. I mean, for a second there, they were saying, oh, you know, how is Big E going to fare, you know, outside of a tag team situation or even in a singles role without his guys with him? The same story could be told with these two. These three guys have been together for so long. So you're absolutely right.
And they alluded to that on Survivor Series when New Day hit Midnight Hour and it didn't give them the win.
Yeah.
And they were like, well, usually Big E's the one handling the big ending part of it.
Yeah.
Xavier Woods handled it at Survivor Series, and maybe that's why that didn't end the match.
Yeah. All right, before we continue, here's a word from the sponsor of today's show, Ritual. Hey, Larson.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what's in your typical multivitamin?
I honestly have no idea, no.
All right, well, listen, no. I'm gonna tell you what's in them. Sugar, GMO stuff, synthetic fillers, artificial colorants, as well as, listen to this, a bunch of animal byproducts. Yeah, I know, that's right. Anyways, Ritual isn't your typical multivitamin. Their clean, vegan-friendly formula is made with key nutrients in forms that your body can actually use without all that shady extra stuff.
Good, because I don't like shady extra stuff. I like to know what I'm putting in this body of mine, and that's why Ritual is great for me. Ritual has a one-of-a-kind visible supply chain, so you always know where your nutrients are coming from.
And Ritual makes it easy because your multivitamins are delivered directly to your door every month with free shipping. And you can start, snooze, or cancel your subscription at any time. Plus, if you don't love Ritual within your first month, they'll refund your order.
You deserve to know what's in your multivitamin. That's why Ritual is offering Going In Raw listeners 10% off during your first 3 months. Visit ritual.com/raw to start your Ritual today.
Again, get 10% off your first 3 months by going to ritual.com/raw. So this match was up next, New Day versus the Hurt Business. There is a weird thing here that we can talk about for a second because there's a lot of shenanigans on the outside. The match ended in a double count out, but
because ref said Hurt Business won. That was the official announcement.
Oh, I just heard commentary saying where they said it's a double count out, and then the ref then
that's what
said,
they said, and then the ref said something to somebody, and then they said, "Oh, winner by count out, Hurt Business."
Okay, all right.
So it seemed like a totally botched type of situation.
It felt like
the ref. They're in a situation where, you know, like we went to the SmackDown here in Sacramento, and they had that same kind of situation with the Jack Gallagher Chad Gable match.
Yeah.
That was really good. And then, you know, they lost track of time and in the double count out, you know, I guess it's possible.
Mm-hmm.
Cause it seemed kind of clumsy at the end where MVP has to get back on the mic and say, hey, New Day, you don't want to win them or you don't want to lose like that. Get back in here. Let's restart the match. You know?
Oh, you never know who's going to invade our Twitch chat when we're doing these things live. Oh. Medusa herself is here in our chat, Larson.
Oh, hello, Medusa.
She's raided us. Thank you very much, Medusa.
Thank you very much.
She has
thank
to come
you,
on the
you,
show one of these days, man. We got to get it. Absolutely. We got to get a chit chat with Medusa at some point. We got to get Agreed. That set up. That's our new goal to have. Let's get Medusa on the show.
But yes, let's do it.
Amazing stories.
Oh heck, like
some ridiculously great stories.
So after the restart, Shelton backdrops Kofi out of the ring. Kofi's selling, like he hurt his knee, and Hurt Business is just going after knee. You're basically destroying Kofi's knee, especially Cedric. Intense heel Cedric is shooting up my list of favorite wrestlers.
Oh man,
so darn good.
He's terrific. I'm sorry, did you already get to the bit where Kofi Kingston took that huge?
Yeah, I just mentioned that. The backdrop out of the ring.
Dude, that looked, and they kept on replaying it. I don't know. I have no idea if that landing was coordinated to make it look like he completely blew out his knee, but man, that looks so rough. By the way, the reason why I tuned you out for a second is because Medusa said, yes, she's taking us up on our offer. Confirmed. We're going to get her in here for an interview.
All right,
for a chit-chat.
We got to work on that. We got to schedule that. Yeah.
Yeah, dude. So they kept on replaying that. Oh my God, that looked ridiculous. But then they started working the crap out of the knee. So it's like, okay, well, I think he's probably
fine. Yeah, he knows the shoot. Yeah, totally.
Our work.
Yeah. So eventually Kofi gets a tag to Xavier Woods. He goes on a run. Cedric, though, hits him with a DDT. Shelton follows Olympic Slam. Kofi gets in there, break up the pin. He takes out Cedric ringside. Shelton goes for a powerbomb on Woods. Woods counters with a sunset flip to get the win for the New Day.
I guess it's just to reestablish the New Day, but I think you're right. I think there's a good story that could be told there. I hope this isn't the last we see from these guys.
Yeah, I hope not either.
After that, we're in the trainer's room. Adam Pearce comes out. He has a giant bruise on the top of his head.
Right here.
Yeah. And Kayla asks him about Braun. And he's like, if it was up to me, he'd be fired. But in the meantime, I've had him escorted out. He needs to have carte blanche, man. He needs to have the ultimate power to be able to fire and hire people, man. That's what I say.
That would be something else.
Anyways.
Hear Adam Pearce say, you're fired.
You're fired. And so anyways, Kayla says, so what's going on? Oh, wait. Was it Charlie or Kayla? Charlie.
It was Charlie. Yes, it was Charlie.
So she says, what was the announcement about the WWE Championship? And he's like, well, I've thought about it. And then Bob Lashley shows up. He interrupts. And he's like, scrap iron. I never would have done what Braun did. And by the way, I was the only champion on Raw that came out victorious last night. I would like to discuss with you situation. And yeah, I'd like to make my case. And scrap iron says, okay, Charlie, excuse us. Bobby Lashley's going to make his case. So after we get back from commercial, Scrap Iron is back with Charlie. She says, what's going on? Part two. Scrap Iron says, Bobby Lashley made his case. And it's something to consider that. And then Randall Keith Orton shows up. He's there to make his case. So he says, give me a moment here. I got to talk to Orton. After that, we have a Lana interview. She's there to make her case about how she feels. And she's like, I feel great. I'm shocked. It was the greatest moment of my career, standing there doing nothing.
This interview would have been much better if she'd actually, like, pinned somebody, you know? No fault to Lana. It's just bad. It's just not the greatest creative. She's saying this is the greatest moment of her career.
I know. I instantly thought of other great moments in her career. She's had some fun moments.
I know.
I mean, Miro was in a tank at one point. That's a pretty great moment.
I know.
Didn't she claim that they in the tank?
Yep.
Probably smelled in there. Anyways, so she's like, yeah, greatest moment of my life. Whoever it was interviewing, probably Kayla, said, okay.
Sarah. It was Sarah.
Okay. Said, you know, the team Raw, one of them dudes might get a WWE championship match. Are you thinking maybe you'll get a women's Raw championship match? And she's like, oh, I just want to live in this moment. That sounds great. Sure, I'd love that, but I'm not even thinking about that. If I'm dreaming, don't wake me up. More scrap iron.
Man.
And
he has found a solution.
Once again, Kayla says, what is happening?
Charlie
says, what's happening? And he says, okay, they've all made their case. A series of three singles matches. Winner gets a triple threat to determine number one contender, starting with Riddle versus Sheamus, which happens right now.
You're leaving out a huge detail. The winner will face Drew McIntyre. Drew McIntyre.
Yes. And yeah, he'll face Drew McIntyre. Oh, boy. That was a lot.
That was fantastic. So next we had Matt Riddle versus Sheamus. These guys have chemistry that's out of this world, man. Just beating the hell out of each other.
I might need some caffeine.
Yeah, you should just go for the caffeine. And Sheamus was holding his own from a technical wrestling standpoint, which is, you know, historically speaking, not his wheelhouse.
Yeah.
Whereas Riddle is I don't know if he still has a record for takedown percentage at USC, but did at one point. So he's a really gifted, you know, mat wrestler.
This was such a tough, hard-hitting match. I give this four stars. Man. I swear, man, I've never wanted to see Sheamus in the G1. I do now. Holy crap. Yeah, this was so good. It's weird. Like, certain guys just have chemistry with each other. They had this match on SmackDown. It was great. This might have been better than that. This was so good.
I know. This is really good. This is really good. So the finish of this, Sheamus was beating the hell out of Riddle. He was just beating him up. Hit a super air raid crash, got a two. He was beating him up. So Sheamus is setting up for a bro kick. He approaches. Riddle collapses.
Yeah.
Sheamus picks him up. Riddle hits him with a headbutt. A kick. Sheamus tries for the clover leaf. Riddle rolls him up to get the win.
Mm-hmm.
Fun match. They beat the hell out of each other.
Yeah.
Just absolutely beat the hell out of each other.
Yeah. This was, that Alabama slam. Really not a fan of that move.
Favorite move, Steve.
Ugh, can't stand it. But, I definitely check this one out if you haven't seen Raw. All right, before we continue, here's a word from the sponsor of today's show, Hawthorne. Hey, Larson.
Uh-huh.
With the holidays fast approaching, it's time to start thinking about holiday shopping. And whether you're treating yourself or shopping for someone else, finding the perfect gift, it's never easy.
But Hawthorne is making gift-giving fun and easy this holiday season. Hawthorne is a premium, tailored personal care brand that's making it easy for guys to feel and smell their best.
Yeah, the first thing you do is you go over to hawthorne.co and take a quiz where you can answer for yourself or whomever you're shopping for. It's really straightforward. And based on those answers, you'll either get some really cool personal care products for yourself or you get to build personalized gifts for everyone on your shopping list.
Speaking of shopping for yourself, Hawthorne is a convenient way to get some really high-quality products tailored for your specific needs. I got myself some awesome mint-scented body wash that's really refreshing and some soothing hand lotion that helps my hands from getting too dried out, especially now that it's so darn cold outside.
Oh, it's crispy out there. Anyways, I got me some deodorant. I also got a giant bar of soap, and I got some thickening hair shampoo. So that makes my locks nice and thick. Anyways, Hawthorne, it's all that stuff is tailored to my own personal needs, and Hawthorne offers free shipping on your order and returns. And if you don't like products, they'll even retailer them for you based on your feedback.
Get special offers for the holidays going on right now by visiting hawthorne.co. That's hawthorne.co. To check out their special holiday offers, hawthorne.co. After that, Lana's backstage. Asuka stops her. It's like, hey, I heard you want to challenge me. And Lana's like, no. That's not what I said. Sarah just asked me about it. And Asuka, she puts Asuka over. And Asuka's like, okay, I like challenges. I accept. I'll see you in the ring. You may go home women's champion. And then she walks away. And Lana is kind of excited.
Let me ask you something. At this point, did you realize that this was going to end up to be a tag match?
No, but I did expect Nia and Shayna to make an appearance.
At this point, my tea leaves, I was like, this is going to just be a tag match because they're not going to have Lana just lose this straight up. Nia and Shayna are going to come out. This is going to turn into a tag match. I was pleasantly surprised by myself because I was already 0-1 with that tag match. Anyways,
you know the tropes, man.
Yeah, Firefly Funhouse was up next, and tonight's episode is about something evil, vile, repulsive, friends. And Bray says, 1 minute, friends are hanging out with you, playing with you, doing nice things. The next minute, they're burning something down, and you get some flashes of Randy Orton when he, and Randy wasn't in the footage, he was just the Bray's old house going up in flames. And he says, they're no good, just like Nikki Cross. And then we get a new puppet, Friendship Frog. What was the? There was a new puppet before. What was it? It was another, and I think
it was the Walrus.
Yeah, it was, yeah. No, there was the Haman Walrus. I thought there was another. It was something like Friendship Frog, but it wasn't. I don't know. Anyways, so Friendship Frog shows up, says you shouldn't let Nikki hop away because I'm very good. I'm doing this right now.
Friendship, true friendship lasts forever. And then Bray suggests Alexa show Friendship Frog what she's going to do to her friend. And then she takes that weird staff thing that Bray's had for a while. I think first made his appearance during the whole Randy Orton thing. And then she beat the heck out of the frog with it.
Yeah.
And then Bray says, let's have a moment of silence for Friendship Frog. And there's some ballad playing. And then they have the life stages of a frog. Tadpole.
Tadpole.
Onward.
High school graduation.
Graduating college, yeah.
Yeah.
And Friendship Frog was apparently 40 years old. After that, we had Asuka versus Lana. Right as the match is about to start, Nia and Shayna come down to ringside to join the commentary team. Apart from like an early pinning combination, Lana didn't really do much. Asuka was dominating. She slides out of the ring to go after Lana. Nia starts talking trash. Asuka picks up some water, dumps it over Nia and Shayna, and then so they like push her and start beating her up. DQ. Asuka wins. And then Nia tells Shayna to clear the announce table. She does. Nia's about to hit a Samoa drop through the table on Asuka. Lana makes the save. Lana and Asuka run up to the ramp. Nia and Shayna grab the mics. Say, you started something. Let's finish it. Get back in the ring. Challenge you to a tag match tonight.
Yeah.
And that's what happened next.
Lana got isolated by Shayna, then Nia, and then probably Shayna again. Nia starts laying into Lana. Lana comes live, gives a little bit of offense. So she was slowly sort of finding, you know, some nerve to take it to Nia instead of just being a beat dummy. But Nia ends up carrying her back to their corner. Shayna tags in, stretches the shit out of Lana. Foot on her neck and started bringing her leg up behind her. Oh, that was rough. And then, like, slammed her leg, gave her some stomps. Lana finally got the hot tag in for Asuka. Asuka hip attacks Nia off the apron. Shayna goes for a back fist. Asuka dodges it, hits her own back fist, a German, a shining wizard to Shayna for two. Shayna comes back with a knee strike. But meanwhile, Nia goes over to Lana, pulls her off the apron, gives her a headbutt, starts clearing or clears a table. Lana fights back, though. She gets her up for a Samoa drop. Lana fights back, gets off. Nia runs towards Lana. She sidesteps, and Nia goes flying over the table. So Lana is sort of on the apron looking at what happened, or she's leaning up against the apron to see what just happened. And Shayna gets distracted. She comes over, and she grabs Lana in a choke. And as she does that, Asuka comes too. And comes up behind, rolls her up, and gets three. So Asuka and Lana get the win.
Yep.
It was like a strong roll up too. I hate roll ups where they just look, the person who's getting rolled up just lays there. In this case, I always love when they start struggling with it as if the person's actually trying to kick out.
I know, it's great.
Small things.
This next bit may have been the highlight of the whole show though. So Matt Riddle's backstage. He sees MVP, walks up to him, says, "Hey, where's Bob Lashley at? I want to wish him good luck in this match tonight." Says his match against Keith Lee will be a fight for the ages. And he's like, "Hey, you're MVP. You're a businessman. I got some ideas I want to pitch to you." So he says, "Everybody loves pizza. Everybody loves yogurt. Why don't you make pizza flavored yogurt?" he says, "You think Lashley has time to listen to all this nonsense?" And
yeah.
Then Riddle's like, "I don't know." Yeah. He goes, "First of all, I'm not your bro."
Oh.
And MVP just about laughed right there.
He started talking and did
he had to stop and do this.
He did a double
get
take.
To cover his mouth.
Went down like this.
Yeah,
he didn't smile. He just looked down and reset.
Yeah.
And Riddle didn't bat an eye. But you could tell he's probably pretty proud of himself because that was a really great little moment.
Just that little, gosh, that was so good. Anyways,
I'm not your bro.
MVP's like, "Hey, Matt, get your ideas together. A couple weeks, we'll meet. If we like them, we'll do business. If not, we'll do business," and then slaps him on the chest.
Bobby Lashley and Matt Riddle in a series making for some pretty good matches there, man. Pretty good matches. After that, we had, speaking of Bob Lashley, we had Bob Lashley versus Keith Lee. Of course, this was just a match between two. Man, I love one thing that I'm really glad about is that they kept Keith Lee there on Raw, where he's just got big dudes. You know, didn't have a lot of those in NXT, but he's got some big dudes. So this is all just strength versus strength. And I love when they're selling Keith Lee. Bobby Lashley just shocked by how Keith is handling the power moves. Yep. He gives him a flatliner. Keith Lee kicks out at one. Lee clotheslines him over the top. He's about to launch himself out, at which point I was like, please don't do that again. MVP tries to trip him up. Lee gets out, starts stalking MVP. Lashley attacks, breaks the count, lifts Lee on his shoulders and rams into a post. And we have our first commercial cliffhanger of the match.
Yeah. Yeah.
After that, we have... the finish left a little bit to be desired. So Lashley keeps control, hits like a huge suplex, goes for the hurt lock, but Lee avoids, gives him a back elbow. Lashley hits a turnbuckle. Then Keith Lee pounces Lashley out of the ring, comes out, gives him a great running fun splash on the outside. And then, as the ref isn't paying attention, Lashley gets back in, and MVP shoves Keith Lee into the ring post. Mm-hmm. Lee eventually, he's out of it, but he's able to roll in on seven. As he gets up, Lashley's ready, puts him in the hurt lock, and when Keith Lee sort of wakes up when he gets into the hurt lock, and he powers himself out, mm-hmm. Lashley mm-hmm. gets his back. Lee does a backdrop onto him, and at that point, MVP attacked, getting the DQ win for Keith Lee.
Make a lot of sense.
It doesn't. MVP has never, he doesn't really do that. Like, he's a lot more strategic and conniving mm-hmm. than just, hey, I'm going to break this up. Lashley has the possibility of being WWE and US champion.
Yep. He needs to win this match for that to happen.
It's just out of character for MVP to do that. That's my main issue with it. And besides that, like, really, like, Keith, like, if they were going to, they let Matt Riddle get a clean win over Sheamus. Why couldn't this have been Keith Lee versus Sheamus? Where, I mean, if Sheamus is a guy that can eat a pin, let Keith Lee beat somebody who can eat a pin, because he just keeps on getting these wonky finishes.
Yeah, no, it's pretty lame. It's pretty lame. After that, we had a pretty good Alexa Bliss, Nikki Cross recap. Following that was a Nikki interview. She says she wasn't the one who gave up on Alexa. Bliss gave up on her. Nikki said she's done nothing but try to help Alexa out, but she's done trying. Last week, Alexa made it perfectly clear that she doesn't want her help. She only wants the Fiend. She says they can have each other. Nikki says she's sick and tired of worrying about Alexa. She only cares about beating the Fiend out of Alexa. So they had their match next. And Nikki tried like hell to beat the Fiend out of Alexa. There's this great bit where she hits Alexa with a Rainmaker, maintains wrist control. And so Bliss starts laughing. Another Rainmaker, still maintaining wrist control. Alexa laughs more. Another Rainmaker. And then Nikki starts ramming Bliss's head into the mat. Nikki hits a corner fun splash, follows a bunch of forearms, and then Alexa kind of gets up from the mat a little bit and starts pleading with Nikki. It's like, and she's looking at herself like, what's going on? Like, she didn't know how she got the funhouse type gear on.
Yeah,
she seems totally confused. Like, what is this? What's happening? She starts crying. She's like, Nikki, help me. And she stands up and she says, I'm sorry. And she hugs Nikki. And right as they embrace, bang, Sister Abigail pins her for the win.
Alexa is doing such good work right now.
I know.
She is doing such good work. I love this stuff. I think it's so strong. It is so strong.
It's really good.
It's really good. Yeah, she gets the win with that Sister Abigail. After that, we had a recap of The Undertaker's final farewell. And then we had Smooth Randy Orton versus AJ Styles.
Seeing Randy tonight reminded me I had to cut my hair. It's getting too long.
Very smooth. This was good stuff. They didn't have a whole lot of time, but they got a lot in with the time that they had. They went to the outside.
AJ was destroying Randy's leg.
He was. He dumped him on the table for their commercial cliffhanger, and then when we come out of commercial, AJ starts working that leg, goes for a calf crusher, gets it, but Orton gets to the ropes. Randy misses an RKO. Then on the outside, with about a couple minutes left to go, the Fiend, excuse me, the red lights show up. Fiend music hits, and he sort of pops up. Randy's on the outside against the barricade, and the Fiend pops up right behind him. I think I'm going to use it for the thumbnail because I got a shot of it. Fiend pops up from behind the barricade and then ducks back down, and Randy's like looking around for him. He gets back in because the normal lights come back up.
He's able
to get a draping DDT on AJ Styles. Lights go back out. That goes doom, doom, doom. And at that point, I realized there's been no retribution tonight, and it's been kind of nice. And do you remember that stretch of time when every single episode ended with retribution and how miserable it was?
It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
So the lights come back, red lights come back up. The Fiend is creeping up from behind Orton. Orton turned around, sees him, recoils backwards, shocked. Lights come back up. He kind of comes to a little bit, turns around. AJ hits him with phenomenal form to get the win.
Yeah. I guess the only mildly weird thing about this is that this didn't distract AJ or the ref seemingly at all. They just like proceeded as if all was copacetic, as opposed to being like, oh my
well,
God,
I'm
there's
sure
like a
they watch, you know, they, I mean, AJ was there. They all are aware of WWE programming from what, 2017, whatever it was.
Yeah, sure.
So they know exactly what's going on here. They know the Fiend is going after one person and one person only in this ring.
Right.
And that's Randall Keith Thornton.
AJ's like, I'm just going
to,
yeah.
It's up to AJ to take advantage of it.
Yeah,
he's never crossed paths with the Fiend before.
Ref
he's got no
like,
beef with the Fiend, and the Fiend evidently has no beef with him.
He's saying, my name is Paul. All right, before we continue, here's a word from the sponsor of today's show, Raycon. Hey, Larson.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you were paying attention earlier, but I mentioned that the holidays are coming up, so it's time to get started on your what? Holiday shopping,
know.
Man. I said the holiday
shopping.
Ah.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I wasn't paying attention to you earlier. But you know what? If you're doing your holiday shopping, why not make the most wonderful time of the year even better with the gift of Raycon wireless earbuds? Right now, you can save big on a gift your friends and family can use every day, whether I'm working out or relaxing at home listening to my favorite holiday jams.
Mm-hmm,
my Raycons become my go-to wireless earbuds. They're comfortable, sound quality is top-notch, and they start at half the price of other premium wireless earbuds.
Yeah, I've been wearing my Raycons during my daily walks, and they pair seamlessly with my phone, and they've got a great noise-isolating fit. So this holiday season, get them a gift they can use for calls, work, or music, for work or play, at home, or on the go.
Heck, you can even treat yourself to a pair. Go to buyraycon.com/raw today to unlock exclusive deals up to 20% off your Raycon order. But hurry, hurry, this offer is available for a limited time only. You don't want to miss it.
That's buyraycon.com/raw. To unlock up to 20% off your Raycons, buyraycon.com/raw. Anyways, let's answer some questions.
Yes. Folsom Joe has some bits. Thank you very much. Broken Wheelchair, we kind of addressed this. Asked, what was the point of the stop-start of the New Day Hurt Business match? I think it's just a mistake.
I think one of two things. It felt like a mistake. It felt like the ref, you know, the refs are supposed to call these as a shoot, basically. Mm-hmm. We've seen it before, like you mentioned. If it's not, I mean, I could see them maybe writing this in as just a way to make it a bit more intriguing. But just the way it was framed and how it went, it did feel like it was a botch.
Yeah, it felt like they were scrambling to cover up for a mistake to get the match started again. That's what it felt like.
Yeah.
Flats says, when they talk, it has to matter, not 15 minutes of aimless threats and the fans did this stuff. Blah.
Well, if you take a look, it's, no, you're right. It's, you know, tonight it opened up with a talking segment. Last week it opened with, wait, was it last week or the week before when it was like Drew's talking, Miz is talking, Morrison's talking.
It went for basically
Randy's
20 minutes,
talking. And it went endless. And it's like they're not advancing anything. Tonight, your eyes are on the TV because it's like, ooh, what is this decision going to be?
And it didn't overstay its welcome.
And you need a hook like that.
And it kickstarted the rest of the show.
Mm-hmm, yeah. You need a hook like that.
Yeah.
Christian asks, do you guys think Alexa should get a mask? I would kind of prefer just some cool face paint, maybe. If you're going to do something, I like the eyes are probably good enough. I think, you know, be a little different, maybe do some face paint. That could be kind of cool.
Awkward Vegas with the sub. Thank you very much. Says, thank you guys for amazing 3 months. Y'all are the literal best. Thanks for the laughs, the knowledge, and all the fun. Here's to 300 more months, friendos.
Thank you,
Awkward
thank
Vegas.
Thank you very much. Yeah, somebody had like a 30-month sub streak going on. I didn't even know we were around for 30 minutes.
This is a good question. Tyler the Savior, how should a Matt Riddle Hurt Business feud go? Well, of course, in 2 weeks when he pitches all his ideas like Shark Tank, they turn them all down. and beat him up. And then we get a Bob Lashley, Matt Riddle feud.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Moses opposes. If the Fiend starts a cult of sorts, who else should join the group? He wants to see Nikki join the group. I think that would give her something to do. That could be pretty cool if that's how this all ends up. And maybe she takes the dive in order to... If she sees that Alexa is struggling and she's trying to get out, maybe it's best that she dives in. Yeah.
And hope not to lose herself. Crossface Chicken Stain. Did Riddle almost break MVP 100%?
Oh, yeah.
And it was amazing.
Oh. Let's see here. Nemo asks, she says, last night they were saying Undertaker had the best wrestling career of all time. Do you agree? Who had the best wrestling career of all time? 30 years.
As far as someone who competed at a high level for that long, it's Undertaker and Ric Flair. Those are the two names.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, Ric Flair retired from the WWE in 2008.
You could maybe add Terry Funk to that. You could add Terry Funk to that.
Yeah.
He wrestled for basically 50 years.
Ric Flair started in what, 75? Something 73, like 75, something like that. And he retired from WWE anyways in 2008, I think.
Or they wrestled for a couple more years in TNA after that.
TNA a couple of years, yeah. So that's a...
So if you're talking about longevity and longevity at a high level, there's only really three names.
Yeah.
It's Flair, it's Funk, and it's Taker.
In the somewhat modern era anyways. I mean, how long did Luthez wrestle?
Oh, yeah, Luthez wrestled forever. That's right.
He wrestled for a very long time.
D. Hay, so who is going to be Asuka's next opponent, or is WWE going to forget about the Raw Women's Championship just like the tag division?
I was kind of surprised that Rhea didn't show up tonight. I imagine
they're going to wait on that. I feel like they're going to wait on that.
I mean, Shayna keeps on talking about how she wants to be tonight, specifically on commentary. She's like, I need to be the next in line. So they might do Asuka versus those two for... I don't know. I don't know until they debut Rhea. I'd be shocked if they waited till the Rumble. I mean, the Rumble's still, what is that, end of January? That's 2 months away.
It's 2 months away.
That's a ways.
G-Man Phi, 54321. Thank you for the sub.
Blake Whitehouse, who do you think is beating Drew for the title next? I don't think a decision's been made on that. If I had to guess who's going to beat him for the title next, I'd probably say maybe The Fiend, if they want to get it on Edge, maybe. Maybe.
Maybe. Maybe. Broken Wheelchair felt like there was a lot of filler between the Keith Lee and AJ matches.
Oh, I didn't feel that way.
No, the Nikki and Alexa stuff was good.
I thought that was really good stuff.
There wasn't a whole lot.
Between what now? We had, let's see.
Between
Keith
Lee and AJ matches, there was only the Nikki Alexa recap, Nikki's interview, their match. I mean, there was that thank you Undertaker package.
There was only like, the Taker thing. I sort of tuned out of the Taker
that
thing.
That was filler. Because we've seen most of it.
Yeah.
But I guess you haven't watched Survivor Series. It's new to you.
Exactly. Let's see here. Ethan Smith. If MVP had retired after that match with Mysterio after the Rumble like he planned, where would the members of Hurt Business be today?
Oh, great question.
Lashley would have zero character. Cedric would be on Main Event still. Shelton Benjamin might
be on Main Event still.
Probably be on Main Event or just a straight up producer.
Ed Fries wants to know if there's going to be an Unsolved Mysteries this week.
Yes. Although it's probably going to be on Saturday, not Thursday. But stay tuned. Maybe you can help solve a mystery. Gregory Faella, should Team Raw just become a faction? If they did, what should their faction name be? No, clearly they
Team
still
Raw.
Have. Okay.
Call them Team Raw.
Just call them Team Raw. Raw. Why Team not? Raw. They wear those same shirts around everywhere.
Mm-hmm. With the USA Network logo on the back.
Alex Foster, who should take the belts off the New Day? Cedric Alexander and Shelton Benjamin.
Yes. Probably should have done it tonight. Crossface Chicken Stain, Hurt Business was the first team in a long time to actually get under the New Day skin. That's true.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I did. I was bringing that up during the wrong time. But yeah, I love that. Cedric with his showboating while he was working Kofi's leg. And we saw the same thing happen last night, but Kofi was doing that to Montez. I thought that was a good little bit of storytelling there.
Yeah. The ultimate coder. Oh, I like that match too. Like New Day was, you know, super cocky at the beginning of that match, you know, and then for them to win via roll up.
Yep.
So, I mean, there's something there to motivate another match. Hopefully they follow through on it.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
The ultimate coder kayfabe wise, what was Retribution doing?
Just playing some video live streaming on Twitch. Or on
yeah, there you go.
On what's there? Are there base. Any? Yeah. They're live streaming on Facebook Gaming because Vince there doesn't know about that yet.
There you go. White Brownie, crazy idea, but Fiend and Alexa should feud with Asuka, trying to get into her head. That'd be cool.
Good luck with that, man. Asuka's great. She's not gonna let you play mind games with her. Let's see here, Marvin McGee. Who should come out number one contender, Keith Lee or Riddle? What do you mean? There's one more guy there who's going to be number one contender.
It's AJ Styles.
AJ Styles. That'll
of
be
the
a,
two names there, though. I'd say Keith Lee.
Yeah.
So he could lose. So he could lose by count out or DQ. Yeah,
count out or double count out or DQ or retribution run in. Yeah.
Jorge D, which wrestler would do the best in Shark Tank and what would be their pitch?
MVP would do best in Shark Tank. Exactly. Clearly. I mean, he owns a business, Hurt Business. His pitch would be, we put the hurting on.
Hurt Business.
Here's the CEO, Bob Lashley. I forget what titles the other guys have.
Night by Night, what Raw superstar should make their entrance to Rob Zerver's rendition of Plus Crier?
Oh, man. Well, easy. This is an easy answer. I was trying to find a way to motivate it. But it's called At the Mall, M-A-U-L. What animal tends to maul people or other animals? Bears. Who's a bear? Cal Jack. He's our friend.
There you go. Dang MQ, which wrestler should win the 24/7 title to end it?
Oh yeah, I didn't know if that commercial that they did tonight was actually in kayfabe, if it was like part of the show, but it was just a commercial.
Yeah, it was a WB Shop commercial, wasn't it?
Right, but I was like, wait a second.
I'm going to say Braun, he wins the 24/7 title and then rips it apart with his bare hands.
Oh yeah, he headbutts it.
Fear and Loathing, is Randy Orton on the verge of doing three straight losing programs with Drew, Fiend, and then Edge? Yes.
Yeah. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Eddie Brock's Venom. Did Vince look not too well to you last night? I thought he just looked old. I
think he's getting up there in years.
70 years old.
Something.
Yeah, so that's just how they look at that age.
Tony V says, remember when Shelton had that weird gimmick where he was in interviews and would just look off?
Yeah, the meme thing. He was the math meme. Yeah. What was that supposed to be? What the Nothing. Hell was that supposed to do? Nobody, you know why, Larson? Nobody asked why when he did that. Nobody asked why.
Nobody asked why.
You got to ask why. If you're a writer, ask why.
Yes. White Brownie asks, how should Roman punish both Team SmackDown and Sami Zayn? Don't think he cares. Don't think he cares about that. He only cares about Jey Uso getting that W. He didn't do it. He takes the brunt of it.
Yeah, exactly.
Totally.
Because all of the respect that the locker room has to be qualified by Jey Uso's accomplishments.
But all has to be Jey as a proxy for them respecting Roman.
Roman and the family, but mainly Roman. Let's just break it down. It's just Roman, really. He cares about Roman.
Yeah, it's Roman.
But yeah, it's all based off of Jay's, you know. Oh, you left the milk 100%. In your car? Well, that reflects bad on me. Now I'm sour. Now I'm curdled.
You're getting me curdled, Jay.
You got me curdled, Jay. Then Jay shows up with some cold milk and Roman hugs him. You're back at the table. Yes.
shares the carton with him.
They both got milk mustaches.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, man. Let's see here. Crossface Chicken Stain. Retribution was trying to collect money to buy an Undertaker cameo. But then they're all sold out. That's in perfect Retribution form. They're all sold out. No more. Oh, man. Anyways, it looks like that's all the questions we have. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. We appreciate it. Until next time, we'll talk to you later. Twitch chat, stick around. We'll hang out for a little bit.
Goodbye.
Help support Going In Raw today by becoming a Friendo Club TV member. You'll get access to new bonus episodes every week, including Friendo Club Arcade, Live Power Rank, Vintage 10 for the Wins, and Ask Steven Larson. Get access to Friendo Club TV today by becoming a $5 and up patron at patreon.com/Steven Larson, by throwing us a sub at twitch.tv/Steven Larson, or by clicking join at youtube.com/Steven Larson.